can't talk right now. I'm making shit. Hold me, Rainbow Dash. I think I have a problem. Hey. How are you guys? Alright, so first things first, yes, I'm back from my hiatus. My undefined hiatus. I've been a little busy with things and, you know, doing some personal stuff. So I got a few new hobbies, you know, I kept myself busy. I wasn't busy with anything important. I just want to say that. But I was important. So I was busy, learning the bass. Okay, you know what? Fuck this shit. I started comic books. This is a good comic. And to top things off, I am drawing on the computer now. So yeah, I just wanted to say all that, you know, I'm back, probably not doing daily uploads though, because that's a bit much for me and my limited attention span, but I'm going to be around, I'm going to be doing videos a bit more, the format's going to always change, because I can never put anything set in stone. I'm a very random person, not really. That's all I wanted to say, so thank you all for understanding, and welcome back. I am the best content creator ever. I had some pretty sick jokes. You know, I played through about half of the tutorial right now, all to realize in my amazing dual monitor setup that I forgot to record the entire thing. So that's fun, isn't it? Because Audacity recorded. Why did Streamlabs not record? So anyway, let me just rephrase a bunch of the jokes here. Basically what's happening is we're playing around the cock in Bikini Bottom because I am a sellout and I like playing what's popular. And that, what do you do with the jellyfish here? Where do they go? They're not in the net. Patrick is trying to, harass me in sexual ways. And that is not okay. But as I was saying, where do the jellyfish go? My game theory, my MatPat game theory is that SpongeBob shoves it up his ass. But you know, that's just the theory. Okay, I'll just play as Patrick. Like, Patrick is the obvious choice for this. This definitely isn't intimidating whatsoever. Go away. Uh-oh. Come at me, big boy. Come at me. I'm not afraid of you. Well, everybody, game over. Patrick died. Well, I'll see you in the next one, guys. Just kidding. I'm not finishing the episode just yet. Perhaps this game is a little more intense than I thought it would be. This is pretty easy. I mean, considering it's a tutorial, sure, but like, really? Okay then. Okay. Yeah. I'll roll with it. Oh, cool. Goofy Goober. Coins. Man, I am going to start investing in Goofy Goober coins. Bitcoin? Bitcoin and Dogecoin? Sit the fuck down. Goofy Goober tokens is where it's at. But, it's time to... Ow! Yeah, it's time to start off with the horror element now. We're going into Glove World. See, the cool thing about skipping the cutscenes is you just dive headfirst into something and you have no idea what the hell is going on. That's a little intense. Some guy legit just died. I mean, damn. Ron Pasher, goddamn. Holy shit. That was great. I love this game. 10 out of 10. But, okay, 0 out of 10. I have to start from the beginning. Don't worry, Spunkle Spob. I'm coming for you. Ooh, the sash ringing hasher light flicker sound effect. There's just straight up a dead person. Mint.
Hola, niño.
I'm getting Hola Niño vibes from this game. Why would Patrick be laughing at that? I forgot that was a jump scare, but I tried playing it off. Essentially, you're right. I just spit everywhere. I don't think I like this too much. I am not good with horror. Like, at all. Okay, so the X equals the start. So, where do I want to go is the question. Okay, let me just quickly read through all this so I actually know what I'm doing. Okay, so I need to look for the conch. Oh, magic conch. See, I suck at horror games. Not because I'm just bad at them, but it's because I don't want to take the initiative and just jump down. I don't want to go to the Kelpie room. Okay, I already hate this. I hate everything about it. Is this Slender? The only thing is, I would much rather play Slender than this. Because I am just mildly afraid of this game. I'm dead, probably, most likely. Oh, I hate this. I hate everything about it. Oh my god, oh no. Okay, well, I'm dead, aren't I? Oh, I hate this. Oh, I hate this. Jellyfish, just kill me. I don't care. Just kill me, jellyfish. Why do I have to play this? Why? Oh, I hate doing this. I love horror games, but I hate them at the same time. Ugh, okay, I need to collect myself here. Like, think about this logically. It's only a game. It's only a game, so the things that are trying to kill you aren't actually real. Like, I really don't like, the Weeping Angel type thing. Or the Slender thing, whichever you want to call it. Where it's like, you need to look at them so that they stop moving. Okay, so right glovey wants to surprise me hindquarters. I think, right? No, left glovey wants to surprise my hindquarters. Okay. I guess there's no real way to deal with this, so I need to gotta man up and gotta grab the bull by the horns. So I found out that the purple guy, Five Nights at Freddy's, he just spawns and can despawn while the shy guy just keeps chasing you. Hate it. I wanna go home. Ah, Jesus Christ, why? Why? I'm looking at you, you shouldn't be pursuing me this far. No, why? No. Stop. Ah! Stop. I found Spunkles, Bob. Please. Have mercy on my poor soul. Did I do it?
Yes!
Fuck. Why? I hate it. I hate it so much. I don't care what rank I get on these. I'm just glad that I'm out of there. This one intense? Yeah, I don't want to deal with that. I don't want to deal with an intense mission just yet. Alright. I would like to grab the baseball bat, but, you know, Patrick being the pacifist he is, I guess he doesn't want to do that. I love Patrick's scream. It's the best ever in the world. 11 out of 10. I remember this one. I don't want to do it. I remember seeing this in a video and I hate it. I hate it so much. Okay, I'll just play the Mr. Krabs one. I really wish Mr. Krabs, when he walked in this game, he had his, like, walk from the cartoon, just like that. Those piano keys. That was cheap. That was cheap, and I don't like that. Cheap counting activities by evading environmental hazards that could cause a ruckus. If they're stirred from their slumber, may Neptune have mercy on your soul. Neptune. Yes, Neptune. Why couldn't it be Poseidon? I don't need to go here yet. Ah, yes. I don't need to go there, so, you know, my house just created an invisible wall. Game logic. I kind of want to run in here, but I also don't want to die in like 3 seconds. Kind of unnecessary how much money you have laying around here, dog. I hate it. I hate it all. Oh yes, a minigun. That seems like a normal thing to have in a house, doesn't it? I mean, everybody should have one, if you think about it. You know what? The best place to keep money is definitely on the shitter. I mean, that's where I put my money. I mean, where else would you want to put it? It's in a perfect location already. Pearl, listen, baby. I love you. But you gotta fuck right off. Is this a safe space? Haha, I'm in my safe space. that's concerning. It's very concerning. I can only assume the rest of them are downstairs. Duh. So I don't know what it means, like, when she's angry. Does that mean I can't be near her? Does that mean, like, can you stop going there? You know, the only place I need to go. I'm gonna be here a while. Pearl, baby. Oh. That was a bit anticlimactic. Pearl fucking dies, part one. Time to take an emotional scene and ruin it. I'm pretty sure Pearl's still alive. You know, that's just my game theory, and my face is blue as fuck. But yeah, I'm pretty sure that Pearl's alive. Because if you've seen the cutscenes or anything, you'd know that, you know, people don't necessarily die, they just get cloned and put into a cocoon. You know, Pearl's probably not dead. I'm probably gonna leave it here. I had to do the easiest mission, just because I'm too scared to do the rest of them. Gonna call it here. Thank you all for watching, and I will see you all in the next one.